going to start off by applying some eyeshadow primer. I'm using my L'Oreal Dupuis. You can use this, you can use any eyeshadow primer just to have the area set and whatever eyeshadows you're going to apply on your face. Want it to last a little bit longer than it should without creasing in any area. I'm applying this basically all in this general area right here. This is sort of like a mask formation here, so I'm going to apply it all along my face. Nose here. Blend it all the way out and we'll move on to the next step. So for this look, I'm going to be using my 120 palette. I'm going to start off with the basic matte white color and just apply it generally in certain areas, starting like so here, bringing it down. You don't want it everywhere, you just want it in the general area, like here, around the eye, because you're creating like a galaxy effect. So the galaxy is made up with different colors, so I'm first going to start with the white. Yes, I'm going to do it in a fast-paced motion just to speed up the process and not make the video so long. So let's do this. Now after you've done with the white, you're going to go ahead and apply like a darker shade of blue. Navy blue, medium tone blue, whatever you like to use. I am using this blue right here that has some sparkle to it. Right here, this blue right here. And you're basically going to outline the white that you've marked already on your face. So it's going to go on the sides of wherever you did your markings of white. Blending brush and just soften up the harshness of some of the areas where I did apply too much of the blue eyeshadow. My bad. And then, you know, go around the whole general area and just blend it out till you get enough full coverage, because you don't want to leave any empty spaces of it in your face. Blah, blah, blah. I can't talk right now. Blah, blah, blah. That's the look that I'm doing here, which is inspired by, get her name right, Clarizley's art. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right, or YouTube name right, but yeah. This is my take on it, because you inspired me. So just soften it up and gradually. Going back with the white and just making that more of a help to blend out the harshness of the blue and also make the white stand out a lot more and soften lots of areas that I left kind of empty. Okay. Now we're going to move on to a black color. Now taking a matte black or a carbon black, which is a very black color. You want to start off right here towards the back, because you want it to be dark in the edges, but once you get it towards the middle, you do want it to be lighter effect-wise. So basically outlining the general area out here. I know it looks like a mess right now, but once it's all said and done, it should look pretty cool. Lots of blendings, you know. There. grab any kind of like pink, bright pink color or even a purple and apply it randomly around the whole area just to add a little pop of color. So I'm using more like a purplish pink color with a little bit of hot pink in the mix. And I'm going to apply it in general areas, like right here. Let's see, right here. That is exactly like the girl. Oh, it doesn't look exactly the same as hers. I know. I'm trying my best to clean it up a bit. This is all experimentation, really, because I don't know. It's going to blend out here and there and everywhere. And here comes the fun part, as she says. I'm using a dotting tool you'll normally use for like nail art designs, or a toothpick, or a very fine pointed brush, whatever you have. And I'm dipping it into my eyeshadow base from NYX and a white base. I'm just gonna grab a little bit and put it on my hand like so as a palette. And then grab some and just like make dots right quick. You apply dots a lot in the general area, wherever you like. Stars go anywhere. And I'm going to do this in a fast-paced motion, so let's get started. Like 95% done. All that's left is to apply the rhinestones and glitter. Now you can do any kind of method you want with the rhinestones. I'm just going to apply a little bit of lash glue on the top of my hand and let's see where I want to put them here and then grab and put them on top, like so. Fix them up so easily, it's awesome. Here, and just put it randomly around your face. All right, I've applied the rhinestones, and I'm adding glitter. This is from Wet n Wild, a big mess I'm making right now. I still have the name for it, but it's just kind of a glitter right here. I'm gonna grab a big fluffy brush, the excess, and apply it like dab across just certain areas to give it some sparkle. You have sparkle glitter everywhere. That's the price you pay with loose glitter, right? Apply it gradually. Alright, and the last and final step will be adding my false lashes. Don't really need to show you that, so stay tuned for the complete and finished look. So for lips, I'm going to apply this dark, deep purple, like so. With her tutorial, she added like a bright pink color. I want to continue. And that is the finished look. My take on it. I hope you like, hope you enjoy. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe, and thanks for watching. Oh, oh, story, I, oh, story.
we're touching. You look at me, it's like you hit me with lightning.